It's 12 minutes past 12 and a great time to bring you this beautiful video about the WTAP rum that I put together special and only for the Espresso Wi-Fi. And the Espresso Wi-Fi represents several devices, peeps. It represents the 3110, that's this tablet, and it represents the 3113, the 5110, and the 5113. I as well created a ROM for the Espresso 3G, and that is the 3100 and the 5100. Okay, these are only two devices are supported by that ROM, but this ROM supports four devices. Yes, that's how it is. So yesterday we got the tablet. It was running Jelly Bean, I think it was, the official firmware from Samsung. And now we have a beautiful, lovely, really nice tablet that I already set it up, and I've been testing it since yesterday. So this is what we're gonna create. You will be on an updated Android version. This is official OmniROM. So thumbs up to Omni for, you know, releasing this version. And it was the final version, so it's the best version ever created by Omni. It's very, very smooth. It's not hanging, it's not lagging. YouTube videos play out of the box, but that all I'm gonna show you after we set this up and after we installed it. So welcome to a new tutorial here at Channel 48. You will need some tools. The tools that you will need are a Windows PC, Windows 7 PC if possible. You will need the Samsung USB drivers. Just Google them, Samsung USB drivers download, you know, don't be lazy. And then you need Twerp. Okay, we have official support by twerp.me. So thank you so much there, Team Win Recovery Project. The files are all there. You need to start with the tar file, and the first tar file that you will be able to download from twerp.me, that will be the 2.8. So we're gonna first install the 2.8. We as well gonna download the latest version from Twerp. Okay, and that one we will use, that's an image, to update after we installed the Twerp 2.8 on the tablet. And then of course you need the ROM. The ROM you can download from the link, the Mega link. This is a ROM that will represent this what you just saw in the video. Remember, the ROM was officially developed by Omni, and it was dressed in 2020 by me, PukRom 2020. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a new tutorial, and let's not talk any longer and let's get started. Okay, hello, welcome again. There we are with the P3110. Sorry for that. This is the Espresso Wi-Fi. This is known as the Espresso Wi-Fi. I connected it to the computer. Okay, and you will need several tools to get started if you want to update this tablet. All right, I'm gonna show you the complete procedure. I will do it nice and slow so you all can learn from this. Okay, this is a workshop, so welcome to a new workshop here at Channel 48, upgrading the P3100 or the 3110. So you will need some files. The files that you will need are Twerp. We're gonna start with 2.8 and Twerp 3110. This is official. This is the latest Twerp that was created for this device by twerp.me, the official. And this is the 2.8 version. Okay, so we will need to put this thing into a download mode. So how to do a thing like that? I think it will be very easy. We're gonna just reboot the system. We say yes, and we're gonna press power and volume down. Volume down and power. Volume down, power. And there we are, in the download mode. You see that? We're gonna hit volume up to be in an actual download mode. We're gonna connect it to the computer. You have the USB drivers already installed. Okay, the Samsung USB drivers. So that means if we're gonna open Audin, I'm gonna go for Audin 3.11, 111. This COM port should light up. You see it's blue. That means it's connected. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to our downloads where we have TWRP 2.8 for the 3110. Okay. And we're just gonna select it and we're gonna hit start. And then we're gonna see what's gonna happen. Boom, it was done. Now the next part is kinda tricky. This tablet is kinda precise and it does not want to immediately go into a recovery from out the download mode. So the best thing to do is to disconnect the cable so it's not, you know, getting any power. And then from out Audin, turn off auto reboot. We're gonna do that in a second because you're gonna see me fail here to get into a recovery. And then, you know, whenever we get into the recovery, because the thing already booted up, at least it did an attempt to boot up, we killed the boot up by pressing down volume down and power. But as you can see, I'm failing here, I'm not getting into a recovery, and the recovery was already replaced back to stock. So in this case you will find out that we will get into a stock recovery. And here you can see that we did not replace the recovery, so we'll have to do the whole thing again. So the best thing to do is to just reboot and go back into a download mode, select the TWRP again, the 2.8, and flash it again. In this case we're gonna turn off auto reboot in TWRP, in Audin, so the thing does not reboot out of itself after installing. I'm connecting the cable again and we're gonna do it one more time. Open Audin again because it must detect the device, and it does that during the boot up of the application. And then we're gonna hit AP again and TWRP 2.8. Now we're gonna go to options here. I'm not sure if you can see it. Options. And I'm gonna turn off auto reboot. Okay, just to make it a little bit easier if you're new to this. And then we're gonna hit start. You should see the blue line there. And now it will be stuck in there. So how to go to the recovery mode? You will have to hold down power and volume down until it goes off, and then volume up, power, and it's gonna give the battery again.
Yep, and that's because I did not remove the cable. So you must make sure that the cable is removed. And now I'm gonna try again and see. And now we should get into a TWRP recovery. And now everything should be fine.
And the volume up, and we press power on again. And we let go when we see the logo. And that should do it. And if not, yes, we did it. So we just installed TWRP. Okay, so at this point it's very important to see if the OTG is, or I mean the MTP is working, and it's crying there, was not installed, blah blah blah. So we take it out and push it in again. No, that means it no se que pase.
Okay, as you can see, we have no MTP connection, so we cannot transfer any file to the device at this point. I as well have no SD card, okay? So I'm gonna just use the internal, and in fact, we should not wipe or do anything at this point. The best thing to do is to reboot back into Samsung, okay? Because your Samsung firmware will still work. Even though we install this TWRP, it will work fine. So let's just boot up into Samsung, and from there copy the files to the internal and then go back into the recovery. by switching the device off, okay, because this device is kind of picky. So we're gonna turn it off after we copy the files, and then we're gonna go back into Twerp.
Okay, so at this point we successfully installed Twerp. That is good. But let's just go home. Let's not wipe anything. Let's just reboot, because I cannot connect to the system. I hit it, do not install SuperSU. Okay, so I'm just gonna boot up into the Samsung system. It still boots. It will not replace the recovery anymore, because we already went into the recovery. You see? So the next time, the recovery will still be there. So at this point, we're gonna connect to the tablet to copy some files to the tablet. And the first file that we're gonna copy to the tablet is the Twerp file. Okay, so let's go to the computer. There we are. Let's see if it connects to the computer. Yes, it does. P3110. Let's get into the system. Okay. Aangesloten als mediaapparaat. Verbinden als mediaapparaat. Okay, and there is the tablet. That's the internal of the tablet. Okay, so now I'm gonna go into my Windows system. That is so amazing from GNU. I cannot do it the other way. Not just like that. In downloads, I should have date modified. Twerp 43110, the image. And I need this one, copy. And we're gonna copy that. Let's copy it to my documents. Because here I have some work that I'm doing on there. I need to be in here for the kitchen. Okay, so these two here, we're gonna copy them one more time and place them on the root of the tablet's hard disk, on the C drive of the tablet. Okay, it still has 4.5 gigabytes free space, so that's good. We're gonna wipe the complete tablet before we're gonna install Android 6. It can already install Android 6. In fact, the Twerp does not even have to be updated. But it's a nicer Twerp, you know. 3.11 is a nicer Twerp. And I think the best way, I've been thinking about it, how to get into this tablet is to turn it off, remove the cable. Okay, it's turned off. You press volume up and the power, and the moment you see the logo, you let go. So volume up and power, let go. That should bring us into Twerp. Okay, so now we already have the files copied to the Twerp or to the internal, like this. Yeah, can you see it? I think you can, right? So we're gonna install image, Twerp image, and we're gonna install it to the recovery. We're now upgrading the Twerp. Flash is complete. We go back home. And we hit reboot back into recovery. So you don't have to press any button. Do not install. You don't have to install the SuperSU because it's outdated. We're gonna wait, and soon we're gonna get into the updated Twerp. We just updated the Twerp
and there it is. You see that? This is the new beautiful twerp that we have for this tablet. And now we're just gonna do a wipe. We can do advanced wipe, Dalvik system catch data. We're not gonna do the internal storage, otherwise we're gonna lose the files. And there you go. It's formatting the drives. All right, and now we're gonna go home and we're gonna hit install.
And there it is, the WTAP Omni
official. You're gonna see it, you see that? Omni mod by Pukram 2020. Okay. So we're gonna install this ROM. We have some backlight reflection, but that does not take the fun away. We are still flashing. And in a couple of minutes, this thing will boot up as something that it never was. And that is thanks to the power of Android and the creativity of Android users, developments by Android developers, and in this case we're dealing with OmniROM, OmniROM M 601, the final build. And we're gonna reboot the system. As you can see, the pop-up of the SuperSU is gone. And we're gonna reboot the tablet. And even though it's gonna show Windows Phone, it's not Windows Phone. Okay, well, we set it up the tablet and you can see it looks beautiful. It's very smooth. Up here you're gonna have all your other applications. See that? In the Square Home settings, you can do all sorts of little tweaks. You can set it to dark in the options. You see that? I set it to dark. Tile size, colors, icons, all sorts of things you can do up here. You can as well buy the launcher. And I'm not even sure what it costs. I'm not connected to the internet now, but you can check it out. You can buy the launcher, and then yeah, but then again, even if you're gonna buy the launcher, Yeah, there is no Google services installed in here, so this is not a tablet to log into your Google account, okay? You might want to do that with the empty version, the version that you will as well find the link to the original file, the file that does not look like this, yeah, the OmniROM. And if you want to go for the all-in-one, including these kinds of look and feels, you go for the other download. Okay, so it's up to you what you want to download. All right, but just letting you know, if you're gonna start out of the box, you're gonna have a store here, Aurora Store. It should work. Let's connect to the internet real fast. Yeah, another thing that I think is really cool, and that Omni was the very first one in all the ROMs to do that, even in the lower versions, is to set the mode to dark. You see that? Now you as well have a nice dark settings, and that will relax you even more. Something else to think of is to go to language and input, okay, and find the USB keyboard and appearance and layout theme. Set it to holo white or holo blue, okay, or material dark would as well look good. I think material dark would look even better with this system. All right, so let's go to the Wi-Fi settings. You see, I changed icon pack. Eh? You can all do that in the launcher. It's a very powerful and as well light launcher. It's not hugging any, you know, too much resources. It's not using anything. So it's just a fine launcher that I really love. And now you can see the keyboard looks really good. So let me log in real fast. Okay, we are connected to the internet. To give you an example, for instance, YouTube by Parafront Team is pushed in, you know. These are the kings of the YouTube app for people that don't use Google services. And now, you know, any ad will play just fine. You cannot skip ads, you cannot block them. Videos, they play out of the box, you see that? As well, ARD MediaTek, that is my German for my German people. Okay, NPO will not work because, I will not say it again. And there we go, we're gonna go to live TV. My brothers from Germany, I really love them, they're amazing people. You see that? Your tablet is playing live TV. Germany TV. If it goes a little bit too slow, you can set from automatic to all these, sorry for that, you cannot see it. All these settings, you know, even 180p. These Germans, they don't play, huh? These are pünktlich people, pünktlich. That means they will not only put HD and demand of you that you need the latest Surface, Google Surface, installed, otherwise, you know, you are stupid and you are not allowed to watch. Nothing like this. These people are even letting older devices watch the news. This is something that the Netherlands can take big example onto. You know, the Netherlands TV is very stupid TV, really. I'm saying it all the time again until somebody's gonna do something about it. You know, these are very stupid company that because they don't want the viewer to watch TV, you know. If we're gonna go with Chromium to my national broadcast TV station website, you know, where every Dutch citizen should be able to go to, you know, to get information from the government whenever, you know, they want to, you know, then you cannot. If you are on a custom ROM or if you don't have the latest of the latest Google services installed. Okay, we want to see the news. Yeah, news. Thing is not even loading. And the app is gonna tell you, you don't have Google services installed, so go away. You are stupid. You know? So, as you can see, this is how the site loads. because it's putting all sorts of things. It's looking for DRM. You know, if you don't have DRM in your browser, if your device does not support DRM, and some devices just don't support DRM because DRM is in fact spyware. Yeah, it's just spyware. It's just rubbish. It should not be there on a national public station. That is stupid. You know, to put DRM on a national public station. I mean, like if the people are not allowed to watch your TV, just say it, you know, then we will not watch your TV anymore. But I think every Dutch citizen should be able to watch the TV. But because of these guys, how they are doing, and they are always crying about money and you know, the way they do it is not good. It's not good. This is not national TV. This is commercial TV. Commercial. It's not national TV. It's not for everybody. Here. Go away. What is this? Whole site is stuck. It's looking for DRM. Cannot find DRM. It's gonna try to load. It's gonna tell us. Could not. You see? Look, let's play. Every good public station should now just play. You see? You can hit play until tomorrow. It will never play. You see, that's why NPO is stupid. Really. They don't want the Dutch people to watch their own blood clot TV. So they piss me off, really. They should take example to Germany, how the Germans do it. I can watch Tatort, I can watch everything, and you as well. You know, if you're from America and you come, you know, you have this room, you can just go and look whatever you want to watch. If something is not, you know, right, if it has a right problem, it will tell you, you know, and then it will just not play. Tatort, there you go. A series from 1 hour and 28 minutes. You can say a sort of short, a film, a movie. You see that? That is Germany. That is Germany. How can Germany do it and be like this to their people, and we from Holland, we deal with stupid company that want us to have all sorts of things that we don't want to have on our devices. They make it hard. That's what I was saying yesterday. We are a bunch of cows that are being, you know, pushed into all sorts of directions by some people, some cowboys on horses. You know, they are like, yahoo, and shooting in the air. And everybody is, all the cows are running exactly in the direction that they want. I don't agree with that. That is stupidness. Anyway, we as well have a podcast player. We have two cameras. Open camera is built in. It's all in there. And if you want more, you just go to the Aurora store. You hit on next. You hit ask. Hit allow. And then you're going to wait. And then you're going to log in as anonymous. Don't log in with your Google. Okay, this is a custom room, guys. Don't use this with your accounts, okay? Because if you're going to get hacked, you cannot come and get your money back from me, okay? What's up? Can we install it? We hit install. Oh, yeah, there's one more thing that you need to do is you must enable unknown sources. But I think it will ask. In this case, it will just ask. So I will be able to run WhatsApp on my, you know, on my tablet as well now. Probably you already could, but it's gonna run even better on Android 6 than on Jelly Bean. Up here we must turn on unknown sources. You see that? And then we go one back, and then in fact we can install, and then the installer should be there every second from now. Let me see where it is. Anyway, you got the message, right? So you can download applications, you can install them. Oh, there it is already. You see, we just downloaded WhatsApp just for the record. It works, you see. You can download applications. The sources are just Play Store. This is the Play Store, the Aurora Store. It's a client from the Google Play Store, okay? And up here, you can just open your WhatsApp app and agree and continue. Put in your phone number, your country, and you're going to get an SMS. Put that SMS number, the code in here, and you're going to be logged on with that number with your WhatsApp. So you as well now have a phone in your tablet, peeps. What do you say about that? Don't you think that it's really cool to, you know, make this tablet something that it never planned to be? And even in 2020, very useful, thanks to it being a nice media player. You can make videos with this thing. You can be very creative. If you know how to use this tablet, you can do a whole lot of things still. Okay? So I wish you good luck, and I say back to the studio.
Okay, we did it. We started at 12 past 12, and it's now 5:37 in the afternoon. Well, there it is, a beautiful tablet. And I'm very happy that I can bring this to you, because this ROM is in fact for four devices, and the other ROM for the 5100 and the 3100 I must still finish. Okay, I must still make it exactly the same way like this one. Unfortunately, I don't have the 3100, so I cannot test it, so you will have to test it for me. Okay, so please do me that favor, test it for me, and let me know if it all works as expected. Yeah, and that's it. Remember, if you're gonna log into any of your Gmail accounts or any other account, Facebook, etc., make sure that you have a two-step verification, that whenever you put in your password, you get an SMS code, so you can, you know, put that SMS code in your account and then log in to the device, so you know at you know, whenever somebody is logging into your account. It's very important when you're gonna install or play with custom ROMs. Very, very important, you know, two-step or even three-step verification. But I don't think that you're gonna do banking on this thing. Okay, I don't want you to do these kinds of things. You know, don't do banking, don't do personal things, you know, that can lead straight up to you. I would not do these kinds of things. However, if you have no other choice, then at least make sure that you have two-step verifications available on these accounts, so you cannot just get hacked by somebody that, you know, could get to the password in some way. I must tell you about these things because there is no official development going on anymore for these devices. We are just, in fact, utilizing these old devices, so you can still use them, including myself. You could put in a navigation application and you could use it on your boat, you know, to navigate around. I mean, like, if you need a navigation for your boat and you go to a boat shop to buy a navigation for your boat, you're gonna need paisa, you know, dinero. That, well, you know, this €20 tablet is now a fantastic device thanks to the, you know, the firmware from Omni, and thanks to, you know, the applications available in the Play Store. So it's only win-win-win for this tablet. But you must know how to use it. I said more than enough. I wish you a fantastic afternoon. Have yourself a nice meal. And if you just woke up, Australia, you know, good morning or good evening. Australia is going to bed now. So Matty, all my Australian friends, big up to you. I see that you're watching my videos a whole lot. My USA people, thank you for joining Channel 48. And of course, all my other people worldwide, you know, big up to you all. And Chile, you know, Unit Packard, thank you so much for that message yesterday. Yes, today is exactly 1 year that mom is not around anymore, and it's a special day. So thank you for mentioning it. And for the rest, I want to say, stay blessed, okay? And don't, stay healthy, all right? And pain and hope, I never hear from you anymore. So leave me a message as well. Goodbye.